Right, let's start. Hope it's
This
audible to everyone.
conference will now be recorded.
Okay, hope it's audible to everyone. Right.
This conference will now be recorded.
Right. So yesterday we have discussed about the different types of objects that an ABAP consultant will develop. We discussed about what RICEF objects development, reports, interfaces, conversions, enhancements, and what forms. Okay, so in continuation to yesterday's discussion, okay, let us see what is the role of ABAP consultant in SAP projects. So if you're an ABAP consultant working in an SAP project, okay, what is your role? Okay, so this is a generalized role here. Okay, again, it depends upon the experience or all those things. Okay, so here as an ABAP consultant, first we are responsible for what? Understanding and analyzing the functional specs. Understanding, analyzing the functional specs. So what is functional specs? I will discuss. Then we are responsible for preparing the technical specs. Then preparing the UTP, unit test plan. Then we are responsible for doing the development, code review and unit testing, transport management, then support, and if required, we might be involved in what? End user training. Okay, so first let us understand the first step. What is this? Understanding and analyzing the functional specs. So we know that in SAP projects, we'll have what different types of consultants. Okay, we'll have what functional consultants. Okay, we'll have what technical consultants. Okay, then we'll have the basis consultant. Okay, basis consultant, and we'll have a separate team for what testing. Okay, so these are the different types of consultants who will be working in what SAP what project, right? So if you take this functional consultant, who are called as functional consultant, if you are from functional background, that is if you are from FICO, SD, MM, HR, okay, non-programming background, okay, they are called as what? Functional consultant. Okay, if you are FICO consultant or SD consultant, HR consultant, MM consultant, okay, like this, all these non-ABAP consultants, we call it as what? Functional consultant. Technical consultant means what? Purely from ABAP background. Okay, so ABAP consultants are called as what? Technical consultant. Basis consultant means in SAP we have an admin module called as what? Basis module. So if you are a basis consultant, okay, it means that we know what basis module, okay, which is related to what? Administration. Right. So initially what happens is in every project, okay, in every project, suppose assume that you're working for some XYZ company like Wipro. Okay, try to understand this. Wipro company is implementing SAP for a customer called as what? Reliance. So for Wipro, who is the customer? Reliance is a customer. Okay, for Wipro, Reliance is a customer, and on behalf of this Reliance project, Wipro will recruit what? Different types of consultants. They'll recruit functional consultant, technical consultant, basis consultant, and testers. Okay, so initially, in the beginning of every SAP project, what happens is functional consultant will interact with what? Customer. Okay, who is the customer here? Reliance. Okay, so functional consultant will interact with what? Customer, and they are responsible for what? Collecting the customer business requirements. Okay, these functional consultants are responsible for understanding the what? Client business, understanding the client business, and understanding their requirements. Okay, so after understanding their business requirements, these functional consultants, what they'll do, they'll prepare what? Functional specs. Okay, before that, there are many other documents. I am not getting into those things. I'm just trying to understand what? Explain the overview kind of thing. So initially, functional consultant will interact with the customer team, okay, Okay, they'll understand, they'll what attend the meetings, they'll attend the workshops, all those things, and they'll collect the requirements from the customer. Then, based on their business requirements, based on their understanding, based on the functional consultant's understanding, they need to prepare different documents. Okay, one of the document is what functional specs, or we call it as what functional design, or in some projects we call it as what PPR, project purchase request, project purchase request. So what this document contains, it contains a business requirements of the customer mapped with what SAP. Mapped with SAP means what already I told. Suppose assume that Reliance has purchased the SAP software. So assume that in SAP software we are having some 60,000 screens, for example I'm saying. Okay, we are having some 60,000 screens. So all these 60,000 screens may not be related to what Reliance requirement. So according to Reliance requirement, they may require only what some 20,000 screens, 20,000 screens. So what this functional consultant has to do, out of the 60,000 screens, how many screens are exactly matching with what Reliance requirement? How many screens can be directly used? How many screens requires modification? How many screens requires enhancements? How many new screens has to be developed? Okay, all those things I can say nothing but what functional specs. Okay, functional specs contains where the business requirements of the customer mapped with what SAP. Mapped with SAP means SAP assume that it contains overall 60,000 screens. Out of 60,000 screens, Reliance requires only what 20,000 screens. So what the functional consultant has to do, they need to understand how many screens can be directly used. So for example, assume that 10,000 screens can be directly used, for example I'm saying. Okay, and then another 2,000 screens requires what modification. Already the screens are available, we need to do the modification according to our requirement. Then another 2,000 screens, okay, are already related to, or assume that they require what enhancement, means they require some additional features in that screen, nothing but what enhancement. Okay, done. Then how many remaining 6,000 screens are what new development, new development. Okay, so overall how many screens we got here? 20,000 screens. So this is nothing but what the what functional specs information. It contains what screens has to be enhanced, what enhancements you have to do, what is the new development you have to do in that new screens, what are the fields we need to incorporate. All those information would be available in what functional specs. Okay, how to do this development, how to do this enhancement, functional consultant doesn't know. Okay, they know that yes, we need to do the enhancement, they know what fields you have to add, all those things, but how to do that development, it is a job of what technical consultant, that is nothing but what ABAP consultant. So initially what happens, mainly the functional consultant only will interact with the customer. Okay, ABAP consultant may not get an opportunity to interact with the customer. So only the functional consultant will interact, and they'll come up with a document called as what functional specs. So once this document is signed off, means once it is approved by at all the levels, okay, the document is going to be what signed off. Signed off means what ready for what next phase. Okay, I assume that the functional specs is signed off. So this functional specs will be given to whom? To what ABAP consultant. What is the job of ABAP consultant? He has to do the development. So blindly they'll not start the development. We cannot start the development directly. What is our job initially? ABAP consultant should analyze this functional specs, should understand this functional specs. Okay, right, based on the understanding we need to prepare what technical specs. Okay, who will prepare the technical specs? ABAP consultant. Okay, or we call it as what TD document, technical design. What this technical specs contains, it contains what algorithms, it contains flow charts, it contains what ER diagrams, entity relationship diagram, it contains UML diagrams, unified modeling language diagram, it contains what objects information. Okay, so every project they may not follow all these things. I'm just giving the generalized information. Okay, the technical specs might contain these things. It may contain all these things, or may contain only few of these things. Okay, right. So how can I prepare all these things? Only if you understand what functional specs. Okay, so if you have any issues in that functional specs, we need to sit with what? If you require any clarifications in that functional specs, we need to sit with what? Functional consultant. Okay, and we need to resolve all our queries. So based on that understanding only, we'll prepare what? Technical specs. And that technical specs will contain what? All these things. Let us quickly understand what are the meaning of these things. Algorithms. Algorithm means what? Step-by-step description of the logic. For example, assume that I am an ABAP consultant. I am responsible for developing a report. A report in the sense an object. Okay. What that object has to do? It has to perform the sum of what? Two numbers. Assume that the object requirement is, okay, it has to perform the sum of two numbers and display me the addition of that particular two numbers. Okay. So this is my overall requirement. So what you will do? Will not directly write the logic. Okay, we need to prepare what? Algorithm. And in some projects they may not prepare. It depends upon the guidelines, all those things. So what is that algorithm means? Step by step description of the program means what you'll do. Step one, you'll say declare what? Two variables, something like this. Declare two variables for storing what? Integers. Okay, declare two variables for storing integers. Then second step is what? Assign values to what? Two integers. Assign values to two integer variables. Okay. Then step three is what? Perform what? Sum of two numbers and what? Sum of two numbers and store the result in what? Third variable. Store the result in what? Third variable. Step four. What is that? Display the value of the third variable. So this is a generalized description. This is nothing but called as what? Algorithm. Okay, means step by step description of your logic. We will not write actually the logic. We will only describe your logic in a general words. We will describe the logic. This is nothing but called as what? Algorithm. Okay, then you might be responsible for what? Designing, drawing the flow charts, ER diagrams, UML diagrams. What are all those things? Pictorial representation of your logic. Pictorial, diagrammatic representation of your logic. So we need to draw flow charts, ER diagrams, all those things. Okay, right? So these are nothing but what? Pictorial representation of your business logic. How the control is flowing from one step to another step. We'll put it diagrammatically. Okay, done. Then objects information. Yesterday I told you, whatever we develop in ABAP, we call them as what? Objects. We should not call them as programs. Even though they are programs, we should not call them as programs. We should call them as what? Object. This object can be in the form of report, or it can be in the form of a table, or it can be form of a screen or template. We have different types of objects. Yesterday we discussed that. Reports, interfaces, conversion. Okay. So that object's information you have to incorporate. All this together we call it as what? Technical specs. So once we prepare the technical specs, what you have to do? We have to what? Submit this technical specs to our supervisor. He is going to do the review. Once it is what? Reviewed. Once if there are no issues in that, he will forward it to what? Other concerned person. Like that, it is reviewed by at a different levels. Once it is approved by all the people, the technical specs is going to be what? Signed off. If any gaps are there, we need to fix that gaps. Means if your supervisor suggests any comments, we need to address those issues and fix that particular issues. Okay, so assume that the technical specs is what? Signed off means what? It is approved at all the levels. So signed off means we are ready for what? Next phase. So initially what we have done, we understood the functional specs. Based on our understanding, we have prepared the technical specs. This technical specs contains what? Technical information related to your object. Functional specs contains what? It doesn't contain technical information. It contains the business requirements of the customer mapped with what? SAP system. Whereas technical specs contains the actual technical information. What objects you have to develop, what tables you have to develop, all those information. Assume that technical specs is signed off. What is the next phase here? You might be involved in preparing what? UTP. UTP is nothing but what? unit test plan. Unit test plan means what? It contains what? Test cases. For example, if you take this only, yeah, what is this requirement here? This is the object which is responsible for what? Performing the sum of what? Two numbers. So what you will do? You will prepare the test case for this particular requirement. How do you prepare the test case? Generally, the test cases would be in what? Excel sheet. Something like this. So see here. Yeah, so assume that this is serial number 1, this is input 1, and this is what? Input 2, and this is something what? Actual output, and this is something what? Expected output. Okay, so serial number 1, input 1. If I give 10 and 20, okay, if I give 10 and 20, what is the expected output? 30. Okay, something like this. Then serial number 2. I'll give minus 10 and 20. What is the expected output? 10. Okay. And then serial number 3. I'll say minus 10 and minus 20. What is the expected output? Minus 30. Then I'll say 4, 10 and 0. What is the expected result? Something 10. Okay. Test case 5. I'll give 0 and what? 10. I should get what? 10. Okay. Test case 6. I'll give 0 and 0. I should get what? 0. So like this, you'll prepare n number of test cases for each object. For every object that we develop in the project, we need to prepare the test case. Test case means what? After developing your object, you need to test your object whether it is working or not. So depending on your understanding of the requirement, we will prepare the test case. We in the sense what? ABAP consultant. That is nothing but called as what? UTP. UTP contains the test cases. Okay, so if you observe this column here, this column is blank, means I have not yet developed the code. This is only my understanding that after developing the code, I need to test my code with so and so input values. If I test my object with so and so input value, I should get so and so expected output. Okay, actual output is what? When I actually develop the code, when I do the testing, what are the result I'll get? I have to draft it here. But as of now, I have not done the development. It is only my understanding that after completing the development, I need to test my object with so-and-so test cases. This is nothing but called as what? UTP. So generally, we'll have a feeling that testing is done by testers. Yes, testing is done by testers only. But before the tester does the testing, whatever the object we have developed, we should also test from our side. Okay, that is nothing but called as what? UTP. Contains what? Test cases. Okay, so these are the initial 3 steps. Any questions so far in these 3 steps, please ask me. Any questions? You can unmute and ask, or you can use the chat box. Partha, I think you have joined, right? With the name Tech Help.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir. I have joined.
Okay, fine. Right. So if there are no questions, I'll move to the next step. Okay, done. So these are the initial 3 steps. So what you have done so far, we have not yet started the development. So this is very important. When you're attending the interviews with ABAP experience, what is your role in the project means generally what most of the ABAP consultants will say is, I have developed this object, that object. Yes, apart from development, what are the other activities you are involved? That is important. Okay, so don't only focus on the development activity. Apart from development activity, we are involved in other non-development activities also. So you have to explain what? All these things. Okay, initial thing is what? We are responsible for analyzing the functional specs. Okay, if you have any issues in that functional specs, we need to sit with our functional consultant and we need to get the clarification for our queries. Once all the issues are what addressed, I need to prepare what? Technical specs based on the understanding of what? Functional specs. Technical specs is nothing but what? It contains the technical information of the objects that we are going to develop. It might include what? Algorithms, flowcharts, ER diagrams, objects information, all these things. Okay. Once a technical specs is signed off at a different levels, we are responsible for preparing the UTP. We are responsible for developing the UTP for each and every object. Means if I am responsible for developing 10 objects, for each object I need to develop what? Separate UTP. UTP contains what? Test cases, which I need to test it after doing the development. So assume that UTP also is signed off. Signed off means what? It would be reviewed by our supervisor. Okay, once it is signed off, okay, what I have to do? I need to start the development activity. So before I start the development activity, there are the different phases where I am involved. Okay, done. Now, development means what? In general, in every SAP project, you'll have what? Three systems. Again, project to project, the landscape might be different, but whatever I'm discussing is a generalized what landscape. So you'll have three systems in every SAP project. One system I can call it as what? Development. Then you'll have what? Quality. And then you'll have what? Production. Okay, development, quality, and what? Production. Okay, so as an ABAP consultant, initially you'll have access to what? Development system. Means what are the objects that I'm going to develop? Okay, has to be developed in the development system. Understood? The objects we need to develop in the development system. Is it clear? Okay, so here when I'm developing it, okay, assume that I develop the object. So here, one second. So this object can be in the form of a table, it can be in the form of a report, or it can mean what? Any of the forms. It can mean any of the forms. Okay, so done. So assume like this. Yeah, I develop the object. After developing the object, what you will do? You are going to test your object. On what basis you are going to test your object? Already I told, before we start the development activity, we will prepare the UTP for our object. So UTP contains what? Test cases. So I have started testing this particular object. Okay, means I am finished with my development. I need to check whether my object is working fine or not. So I'll test my object with all the test cases. When I'm testing, I'll get what? Some results. Huh? I'll get some results. I need to draft that results here. Okay. Suppose assume that I'll get the result here as something 30. Here I'll get it as 10. Here I'll get it as something minus 10, 10, 10, and what? 0. So what I have to do at the end, I need to check whether the actual output is matching with what? Whether the actual output is matching with what? Expected output. Yes, these two are matching. Fine. These two are matching. Fine. Okay. But if you observe here, these two are not matching. So what is the meaning? There is some issue in my object. Either the expected output is wrong, or what are the actual output you are getting is wrong. Okay, it can be any of the case. What you have to ensure is both the actual output and expected output are what? Same. Then only I can say that my object is working fine. But out of the 6 test cases,
well, now we record it.
One second. Yeah, please mute your speakers, Jyoti. Yeah. Okay. So here, what you have to ensure, all the actual output of all the test cases should match with what? Expected output. So out of 6 test cases, one of the test cases is not working, not matching. So if it is not matching, what is the meaning? There is some issue in my logic. Something went wrong. So I need to rectify it. I need to retest it. So at the end, what you have to do, we have to ensure that all the test cases are what? Matching. And if required, you'll be doing the attachments here. You'll also attach the what? Attachments. Means you'll have a proof that you have tested your object and you got so and so results. Understood? So for every test case, generally we'll assign what? Attachment. So that it'll act as a proof. Understood? So what you have to ensure? That actual output of all the test cases should match with what? Expected output. Then only I can say my object is working fine. So assume that you have done the development, my object is working fine, all the test cases are working fine. So once the development is finished, what is the next step here? So you can observe here, development. What is the note I gave here? See, development is nothing but what? Development of objects in which client? Development client. As an ABAP consultant, you will have access to what? Development client. Will test our object in the development client with all the test cases. Okay, done. So assume that all the test cases are working fine. You have done the unit testing. What is the next step? Is the unit testing. Unit testing is what? You need to test your object with all the test cases and ensure that actual output matches with what? Expected output. So done, you have done the testing. Everything is working fine. What is the next step here? See, this is important. Code review. Code review means whatever the code you have written, whatever the object you have developed, you need to check whether we have followed the coding standards. In every project, you will have what? Some coding standards. We need to follow that coding standards and develop the objects. Okay, we need to follow the coding standards and develop the objects. Okay, so before we start the development, we need to go through that manual. Blindly, we should not develop the code. Okay, I repeat this. In every project, when you join the project initially, you need to go through the coding standards which need to be followed in the project. According to that coding standard, we need to develop the objects. Done. Then you have to check for what? Performance issue. Okay, I developed the object, I'm getting the result. But it is taking lots of time to give me the result. Assume that I developed a program. When I am testing my program, it is taking me 5 minutes of time to give me the result. Okay, so I need to check whether I can improve the performance so that instead of 5 minutes, it should take me only 2 minutes. So I need to check for what? Performance issues. Understood? Writing the code is not important here. How better we write the code is important. Understood? So as an ABAP consultant, we should not focus only on getting the output. We should not focus on achieving the output. We should focus on how better we write the code. Understood? I can write the logic in 100 different ways, but we need to go for a better way where it will take less time to give me the results. That is nothing but what? Checking for what? Performance issues. So once we are okay with all the performance issues, once you have followed the coding standards, and once you are done with the development, what you will do? What is the next phase here? Transport management. So what you will do here? We have developed the code. We have tested our code with our own test cases, and we ensure that all the test cases are working. But someone else has to tell me whether my object is working fine or not. Who has to tell that? Tester has to tell that. The tester will prepare what? His own test cases. So what you have to do? Whatever the object you have developed in the development client, we need to move that object. We need to transport that object from where? Development client to what? We need to move the object from development client to quality client. Am I clear? So when you transport, what happens? The object will come and sit in what? Quality system. So assume that the name of this object is, for example, object one. Object is nothing but a program, but we should not call it as a program. The recommended terminology is what? Object. So the same object will come to what? Quality system. Okay, who will have access to development client? Already I told, ABAPers, the technical team, will have access to what? Development client. And quality system access is most of the time is given to what? Testers. And sometimes in some projects, access might be available for some of the functional consultants also. Again, depends on project to project. Okay, right. So object is transported to what here? Quality system. What the tester will do? Tester will be ready with his own test cases. Who has prepared these test cases earlier? By ABAP consultant. Means ourselves will prepare the test cases. But again, tester also will prepare his own test cases according to his understanding. Understood? So assume that he also prepared some 10 test cases for this particular object. Okay, we have prepared 6 test cases. Assume that the tester has prepared some 10 test cases. Okay, right. So when the object comes to a quality system, what the tester has to do? He has to test that object with all the test 10 test cases. Assume that out of 10 test cases, only 6 are working, another 4 are not working. Okay, try to understand. When the object is moved from development client to quality client, tester will start testing your object with your own test cases. Okay, so as part of the testing, assume that out of 10 test cases, only 6 are working, other 4 are not working, means we are not getting the expected result. So what the tester has to do? Tester has to intimate that issue, intimate that problem to the development team. So what he will do? He will not call the development team, or he may not mail the development team. Generally, in what bigger organizations, what happens is, one second. In bigger organizations, we will maintain some softwares, or we call it as issue tracking tools, or we call it as what, incident tracking tools, some software. Okay, there are many softwares. Some of the softwares are Mercury Quality Center. Try to understand Mercury Quality Center. What else? HP Quality Center, or what is the other tool which I know? Remedy tool. Like this, there are many tools available in the market. Okay, so what is the purpose of these tools here? These tools, these softwares, will have some columns, something like this. Try to understand this. You may have some columns here. Let me draw this so that you'll understand the actual scenario. Yeah, so it will contain different columns. Again, the column names would be different from tool to tool. Assume that this is ticket number, nothing but issue number. Okay, and issue. Okay, and here you may have the what? Another column like what? Issue attachment. Then you might have a column called as priority. Okay, you may have a column called as assigned to. You may have a column called as status. Okay, you may have a column called as transport number. Okay, you may have a column called as what? Delivery date. Okay. Like this, we'll have n number of columns. I'm just putting some important columns. You'll have another column like resolution. Okay, resolution, something like this. Okay, so what we are trying to discuss here, the tester has started testing your object in the what, quality system. He has encountered some issues. That issues, he needs to report it to what, the development team. So what he will do? Okay, in general, you will write that issue, you will write that problem to this particular tool. Okay, so whenever an issue is written to this particular tool, a ticket number, a issue number, or we call it as incident number, will be generated. Okay, so assume that the ticket number here is what, 1001. Issue means what? You will describe what is the issue, and you will attach. Okay, we should have a proof now, what is the issue. So you will do the attachment also. Okay, priority. Again, you'll have different priorities here, like high priority, low priority, urgent priority, medium priority, something like this. Assigned to means who will have access to development system? ABAP consultants. Okay, every ABAP consultant will have their own user ID and password. So assume that the consultant names are ABC1, okay, ABC2, understood? All each ABAPer will have their own user ID, ABC3, something like that. So assume that there are three consultants in the development team with these user IDs. Okay, assume that this issue is assigned to which user? ABC2. Status. Okay, status. I'll say it as what? Open. Or I'll give the status as what? New. Understood? So these six columns will be filled by whom? Tester. Like that, he will report all the issues, something like this. the issue description, issue attachment, priority. Assume that this priority is what urgent, and this is assigned to what ABC2, and then 1003 again some issue. Okay, this priority is low. This is again what ABC2. This 1004. Okay, so and so done. Assume that this priority is something what medium. Okay, this is assigned to what ABC3. For example, what is the status of this new? Okay, here also the status is what new. Here also the status is what new. So these six columns are filled by whom? By tester. Okay, you will report that issue into this particular tool. Initial status of the incident ticket is what new, and it has been assigned to what so and so user. Done. So what the development team will do after I transport the object, I will not sit idle. The development team, okay, on a periodic basis, they should log on to this particular tool. Means every half an hour, 1 hour, I need to log on to this tool and check whether any issues are reported against my name. So assume that my user ID is what ABC2. My user ID is what ABC2. So what I'll do, every half an hour, 1 hour, I will log on to this particular tool and I'll check whether any issues are reported against my name. So against my name, how many issues are reported? 3 issues are reported. So what I have to do? I have to start fixing that issue. Which issue you will fix first? It depends on the priority. Okay, assume that in urgent means, in my project, urgent means I need to fix it in 2 hours. I means I need to fix it in 4 hours. Medium means I need to fix it in 8 hours. Low means I need to fix it in 2 days. Like that, project to project, you may have different time period. Okay, so the topmost priority is what? Urgent. Okay, done. So what I'll do now, I'll continuously monitor this tool and I'll check whether any issues are reported against my name. So if any issues are reported against your name, you need to start fixing that issues depending on the priority. So what is that issue first? I need to fix, what is my user ID? ABC2. So against ABC2, how many issues are reported? 3 issues. Which is the one which I have to fix first? Urgent. So the moment I start fixing, what I have to do? I have to change the status from new to open. Initial status is what? New. Now, since I started fixing that issue, I need to change the status to what? Open. Where I will fix the issue? Again, I'll fix the issue in what? Development system only, because ABAP consultant will have access only to what? Development system. So again, this is object one only. Again, I've started making some changes in my code, changes in my program logic, in my business logic. So I've started fixing that. So assume that I've fixed it, I've retested, I'm happy with the latest output. What you will do now, you will retransport it. You will retransport the object from where? Development client to what? Quality client. So you will retransport. So when you retransport, some transport number will be generated. Okay, so we'll see that practically later on. I need to write that particular transport number. So assume that my transport number is so and so. For example, I am giving, this is nothing but called as what? Change request number, or we call it as what? Transport number. Whenever we transport any object from one client to another client, you will have some change request number, TR number, transport request number. So I have to draft that number in the tool, incident tracking tool. Okay, right. Delivery date. Delivery date means when you have fixed that issue. Assume that today I fixed that issue, so I'll write the date 12th July. Okay, then I need to write the resolution for that issue. Why the issue has been raised? Whether it is a functional issue, whether it is a new requirement, whether it is a testing issue, whether it is a data issue, or whether it's a technical issue, all those comments you have to write. Understood? If I write functional issue, right, means it is a problem of whom? Functional consultant. He has not given the requirement properly. So you need to justify it. If it is a functional issue, you need to justify it. That so and so that initially the requirement is given like that. Or assume that it is a new requirement. Means initially the requirement is not given in that way. Now the requirement got changed. Or what is a testing issue? Testing issue means what? The tester itself might have not have tested it properly. Or technical issue. Technical issue means it is our fault. Means we have not written the logic properly. So that resolution, that reason for issue, I need to draft it. Okay, just like that, I cannot write functional issue. If I write it as a functional issue, again, functional concern will come to us. You will ask you why you have written it as a functional issue. Okay, we should be able to justify it. If you write it as a testing issue, again, tester will come to us. So whatever the reason you are writing, we need to justify it. Okay, right. So initially, when I started fixing it, the status is what? Open. When I fixed it, I need to change the status from open to fix, because I fixed it. Okay, so what happens? The same object is retransported to what? The quality system. So this is same object one, but this is what version? Version two. This is version one. So you'll have multiple versions. That is version one and this version two. So what the tester will do now? Tester will test this object. Tester will test the latest version. If he is happy with the what changes you have done, he will change the status from fixed to what? Close. He will change the status from fixed to what? Close. If the problem is again, I am getting a different problem, what he will do? He will again reopen the issue. So he will write the status as what? Reopen. Reopen is what? Same issue has been what? Reopened. Understood? So like this, the testing will be carried out. If he is happy, what he will do? Again, it will be transported to a production system. Okay, it will be transported to production system. Who will have access to the production system? The customer, the end users. End users, the customer team will have the access to what? Production system. Production system means where the live business will happen. Okay, so the customer will start using our what? Objects in live. Okay, while using the object also, customer also might face some problem. If he is also facing the problem, what he will do? Again, same thing. He will also report that issue to what? The incident tracking tool or issue tracking tool, or we call it as what? Fault tracking tools. Some softwares. Okay. He may use the same tool or he may use a different tool. Again, project to project. In some project, what happens is both in quality and production, they might use the same tool. Sorry. In some projects, they'll be using what? Different tools. Understood? So again, if the customer also is reporting the issue, again, what you will do? On a periodic basis, we need to log into this tool and we need to check whether any issues are reported against your name. Okay, that is nothing but your next step here. Transport management. What is this here? Before we do the transportation, we have to do all these things. These are all practical oriented. That we'll be discussing later on. We need to do something called as perform extended program check. We need to release the task. We need to release the request and send the screenshot to the concern. Okay. Understood? Transporting means moving the object from what? One client to what? Another client. Before transporting, you need to do all these things. Again, we are not in a position to understand this. This is practical oriented. We'll discuss that as and when required. Okay. Assume that you are transported to quality. So in the quality, tester will test what? Test the object. You will raise some issues. That is nothing but called as what? Support. What you will do in the support phase? You will fix the issues. Okay. You will fix the issues raised in what? Quality or what? Production phase. You will fix the issues raised in quality or what? Production phase. And you will update the tools accordingly. Means you will update the status like this. You'll write the resolution, you'll write the reason, you'll write the delivery date. All these things comes under what? Support phase. So once everything is resolved, you might be involved in what? End user training. Actually, you may not be involved in that, but again, depends on your experience. Okay, if you are a senior guy in the project, you might be involved in what? End user training. Means we will train the end user on how to use our software, how to use this particular SAP software. So this is again what? Optional step. So you'll prepare the manuals and you'll train the end user on how to use the finished products. Understood? If you purchase any product, you'll get the manual. Manual contains what? It contains information about how to use the product. So you're involved in all those activities. This is an optional phase, but up to this, I'm sure that every ABAP consultant will involve in the real time. So this is the role of what? ABAP consultant in SAP project, whether we are 1 year experience or what? 10 years experience. So in the interview perspective, what is your role in the project means? apart from talking about the development, we should also talk about these things also. Right? So any questions in this, please ask me. Any questions? Done. So we are done with all the theoretical part. Okay, so we are ready to start with what? Programming part. So far in the last 3 days, what are the things we understood is what is ERP, okay, and what else? We understood the difference between programming languages, databases, all those things. Then we understood what kind of objects ABAP consultant we develop, that is RISE Serve development. And today we understood the role of ABAP consultant in the entire SAP project. Okay, so this is the theoretical part. Tomorrow onwards, what we will do is we will start with the programming part, how to log on to SAP system and how to develop your programs. Done. So any questions, please ask me. Otherwise, I'll wind off for today. See, actually, I'm going little slow and I'm taking only 45 minutes. As I told you, there are some more people who are going to join probably from tomorrow or from next week. Okay, so they already attended these things. Right, so tomorrow onwards, I'll start with the programming part. Okay, and one more thing is it is raining in there are rains from last 2-3 days in Hyderabad, so there might be a delay in starting the class. Okay, 5-10 minutes here and there. Okay, so understood. Definitely, I'll send the meeting ID. If any issues are there, I'll communicate it before only. Okay. So tomorrow also we'll be starting. I'll sending the meeting ID between 6:30 to 6:45. Okay. Done. And today, most probably, I'll share the recordings also. Whatever we discussed today and the last 2 days. Tomorrow onwards, we'll start the practical part. Okay. Jyoti, any questions? Jyoti, Latika, others, any questions? Feel free to ask. Okay, so if there are no questions, I'll wind off. I'll share this material and recordings by afternoon. Okay, tomorrow onwards we'll start the programming part. Chal. Yeah. Okay.